Eastern red cedar. Is it a weed or a valuable native tree? In this video, we're going to be looking at the pros and cons of red cedar. It does have an image problem because of its aggressive nature.
Well, one of the benefits of the red cedar is that it grows well on marginal land. The red cedar produces a lot of biomass under these sort of challenging conditions that helps to improve and increase the soil organic matter.
Soil scientist Tom Sauer investigates what happens to soil beneath red cedars.
Our measurements have indicated that there is generally a positive benefit on soil health from red cedar plantings. We've seen improvements in soil organic matter, infiltration of water, and root penetration resistance, all at nearly all of our sites in the study.
Area Wildlife Manager Nicholas Snavely is with the Minnesota Department of Natural Resources.
So not only does red cedar provide thermal cover for wildlife, but it also provides food for birds like cedar waxwings that will come through and eat the berries. And eventually potentially spread them, and that's why we need to manage a habitat with red cedar so that they don't become too prolific in areas that we might not want them to be.
Red cedars need to be managed here on this site because of the proliferation of them over the years that it has been neglected.
Clearview Elementary School Forest has done some forest management practices here, trimming back some of those dead branches in the understory that have been shaded out so much because they're so thick, and opened it up more so that critters and even students can enjoy the school forest better.
Red cedar is an alternative host for cedar apple rust, a fungal disease that causes damaging leaf and fruit spots on apple trees. Because of this disease, it's recommended you keep red cedars at least 500 feet away from apple trees. Red cedar plantings are valuable for agroforestry, which is the intentional integration of trees and or shrubs with agricultural crops. Red cedars can be planted in a single row or multiple rows for windbreaks. It is a species that can be used in alley cropping systems. Red cedars can be planted in riparian forest buffers, which helps protect and improve water quality. Red cedar trees that have been cut can be used for stream bank stabilization.
So stream bank restorations using eastern red cedar trees has been practiced quite a bit as a potential market for these red cedar trees. It's been great to see them being used instead of rock or riprap on the banks of streams that have eroded, using special techniques to hold them in place and provide habitat for fish and a more natural boundary versus straight rock walls.
Red cedars can generate non-timber forest products that can produce income for landowners.
It's a rarity to have a 38 plus acre forest on school property, and it allows our children to come outside. It also allows us to do some fundraising opportunities, such as making crafts and various ideas, things that the children and parents come up with that we can sell as our funding source.
And for some reason, red cedar sells better than any other wood. And part of it is that people want to smell it. They want to see if they can smell that aromatic smell that it has. And the other thing is, I think it's just the red color.
Researchers are investigating ways of using red cedar to make medicines, and other products are under development.
Well, red cedar is a very adaptable and durable species. It can grow in a lot of different climates, on a lot of different soils, and in different landscape positions. And all of those factors contribute to it being a good choice if you're interested in sequestering carbon, pulling carbon out of the atmosphere. Just because it's such a durable, adaptable tree, it's a survivor.
Eastern red cedar, is it a weed or a valuable native tree? Clearly it's both. If planted in the right setting and kept in check, red cedars certainly have a place in the landscape.